Hello, it's Mike McGinnis here. I am the development consultant for Hockey Alberta in the Edmonton area. This video is going to go into shooting head up versus head down, when and when not to. This is something that I've been watching for years and years now. It's absolutely drives me crazy when I hear and watch the CBC or whoever broadcast and somebody scores a goal and they come in and the announcer say, "Oh, he had his head up the whole way, he had his head up the whole way," and then there's numerous goals scored where people aren't even looking anywhere close to the net, and not a mention of that. It's almost giving a false pretense that every shot you should have your head up. While I agree with in training you should always work towards having your head up when you're training, that's one thing we do a really bad job of as coaches is not training that in our practices, not having cues in place for young players to get their head up while shooting or passing or stick handling, doing anything. We let them default to looking at the puck a higher percentage of the time than looking up. So we're going to go into some stills and some videos here and just walk through it. One thing in the studies, in what I've found, is I think that you can shoot harder with your head down than you can up. And some of these stills, just gonna let them run here. So this is Chara, as you can see, no helmets. So this is hardest shot competition or in warm-ups. So looking directly at the puck, and then on the follow-through, his eyes come up. Here's Shea Weber, same thing. Looking at the puck, on the follow-through, his eyes are up. Dustin Byfuglien, eyes are right at the puck. Al MacInnis. And here's an example of, in a perfect world, what it should look like. When you're making contact with that puck, your eyes should be up. But as we could see by those examples, when you're going for harder shot competition like those guys were, it seems like you can get more power by not having to lift your head up. And anybody who's played hockey has experimented with this, including myself. And I can shoot a lot harder when I'm starting looking at the puck rather than when I'm skating with my head up and hoping to get good connection with that puck. And that's a train and learn skill. That's something years ago when I was a player, that's something I really never learned or was never taught and never figured it out, because I could shoot hard, but I could never really knew where it was going. And you turn into a shin pad assassin if you just bury your head and blast it. So it's a trained skill. It can be taught. We'll just get through, go into a couple things here. This is Ribeiro with Dallas. As you can see, his eyes right now, his head is down. He's looking at that puck. As he shoots, now you can see his eyes have come up. So now his eyes have come up when he's in about mid-swing of that shot. So if you think about that process, look, he was looking at the puck, dragging it, winds up halfway through, lifts up his head, eyes are up, and you can control the stick as you go. Here's a good example. So right here, you can see this, although this is at the end of the period, I think there's only a couple seconds left, but eyes are up here for the most part. So he takes a glance, he's looking towards the net. The net is right behind Backes here. So this is Penner, walks in over the blue line. You can see he took a glance. Now he's down looking at that puck. Everything he has into it, and eyes follow it up. Turns into a goal last minute of the period, but again, it was right at the end of a period, and there was nothing there except to blast it and hope for the best. So here's another goal, quick shot in the slot, a little one timer, and here you can, I don't know, this is a different goal. That was a, sorry, that was a separate highlight there, but this goal here is the one we're looking at. So as you can see, this guy, it's coming down. Eyes are looking at that puck in this instance. Net is that direction. And this is another example of that. Contact with the puck. Still looking down at the puck. Contact with it. And now the eyes are going up. But in that instance, he knows where the net is. And there's really, there's no checking to see where the goalie's positioned. He knew where he was shooting without having to look up at the puck or look up at the net. Turns into a goal. This was a clip I got from, I think it was the Memorial Cup a few years ago, Nathan MacKinnon. So, pretty good player. Here we go. Look at the eyes. Look at where his head is positioned. Again, that those eyes are pretty much straight down looking at that puck. Of course, he's in traffic. It's tough to handle the puck with your head up while you're in traffic. That's a pretty high-end skill. But here, you can see the release of that puck. His skates are going this way. He's shooting back across his body. His eyes are down, and puck is going that way. So there's a whole bunch of different angles happening in this shot. Quick shot. Ends up beating the goalie on this one. So, one thing I ran across too in regards to this is the Players Tribune. There was an article in there by Jonathan Quick about the shooters he faces and who he thinks is the best. And this is what he had to say about Pavel Datsyuk. Datsyuk is probably the most deceptive player in the NHL. He's a magician in the way that he's able to hide the puck on his stick. Part of it is his hardware. He uses a type of blade that is pretty unusual in the league. It's a lot thicker from the top to the bottom, and somehow when you combine this with his quick release and the fact that he's hardly ever looking at the net when he shoots, it's extremely difficult to track the puck coming off of his blade. So, again, everything is so situational. If you watch any of my videos here, you're going to find that that's the common theme is never say never, never say always when it comes to skill development, because you're going to use skills and do things that you've probably been told not to do at some point in your career. And you know, like I said, watching the Hockey Canada or the CBC and whatnot, when the announcers are always saying, "Oh, he had his head up the whole way," or whatever, you never ever hear them say he had his head down on that one. But it does happen more than we'd like to know. I'd really like to do a study on it with NHL video and see how many goals are scored with players' heads up and with players' heads down. I think we'd be absolutely shocked at what the numbers are. And this one, kind of the next step of it, this one's Malkin coming in on a you know, an old highlight reel of his. But you can see here, you know, from probably the blue line to the ringette line in, I don't think he ever looks up once. So there, when you're making moves like this, you've got to look at the puck. But the whole thing was, the whole sequence was pretty much, I'm gonna just rewind it, slow it down. The whole sequence, as you can see here, head down, head down, head down. When he gets to the last little bit, when he gets near the net, he barely even takes a look up. He might have a little bit of a glance with peripherals there, but it's all feel and peripherals and processor that made that play. So again, not always do you have to have your head up. And here's another example. I think this is Pouliot when he's with Boston. Cut across, head down, looking at the puck. Never lifts his head up. Shot, goal without looking at it. So, and here's now we're going to kind of switch into examples of what it should look like. It's going to happen when they have their head down. But again, in training, you always want to train players to be able to do it with their head up, because default is to shoot and make plays with your head down in practice. Conducted numerous experiments over the years with coaches and players, and the default is to play with your head down when you're not challenged to have it up. So here's some examples of good head-up shooting. So this is Stecher with Vancouver, rookie this year, but you can just tell his skill set is hopefully going to set him apart in the next couple of years, just from watching highlights and from what I've seen of him so far. He's got somebody's developed him properly. He does things extremely well. So here you can see never looks at the puck once through that whole sequence. Picks it up, drags it, and shoots it all without even looking at it. Head up the whole time. This is Doughty. So right here, fake shot, drops that guy. You can see here he's actually checking the puck. His eyes are down right here. He's actually having a look at it. As it goes across, now he picks his head up. He's got control of where that puck is, and he's head up from here on over. And never has to look back down at it or understand or try to figure out where it is. So those are some examples of what it should look like. And it's a very difficult thing to do as a coach, but again, how I was taught was maybe every once in a while you'd hear, get your head up or whatever. But when you're doing drills, when you're doing walk across the blue line or anything in regards to shooting with players, you'll be able to control your practice in a way that you can put things in place that make them have to get their head up, whether it's an assistant coach holding a number of fingers up or just getting attention of the players. And a good way to assess this is if you go stand behind the glass during your warm-ups when everybody is shooting in the regular butterfly pattern in your warm-up before your game. You'll be amazed at how different it is when players are coming in over the blue line. The last time they look at the puck is at the blue line. They can handle it and shoot from the blue line in. Other ones look at the puck probably 90% of the time and glance up a couple times. Other ones have to check it about 5 times. Some have to check it once or twice. It's amazing the differences in the way players come in. As soon as they step over the blue line, pick a player, watch his eyes, and see what he does as he's coming in to release that shot. And even if you want to set up a video camera, you'll be able to study what your team does and how they shoot and help players individually with being able to get their head up and teach them how to do it in practice. So please make some comments to this. This is something that I'm really passionate about. It's probably gonna drive me crazy until the day I die because it's really interesting, and there's so many variables involved in it that it's something I'm going to continue to study going forward. So if you have any information on this or want to make a comment, please do. Always willing to discuss this kind of technical information and try to grow and listen to other people's opinions. So hope you enjoy this, and hope to hear from you. Thanks.